Okay. Long time no see. I wanted to make more videos, but I just don't have peace and freedom at home. You can't live in peace if your wife doesn't want to. And as I'll say, this is not my wife's. This has something to do with the Mandela effect. She pops up and vanishes, and it's a nightmare. So, nevertheless, the most important part is so. I have quite some virtual machines here. So that's Windows running on a 2 TB hard drive. It runs virtual too. You have to use the same UUID for the machine. Otherwise, Windows might say, oh, you reinstalled it on a different hardware, blah, 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 and you get registrations trouble and back and forward. And it's a nightmare. Oh, that COVID. Then MX-19, this one, it's running on bare metal too. That I just called bare metal. Right now I'm on Ubuntu 18.04. The 20, I don't like Flatpak and all that stuff. There's stuff going on I really, really, really don't like at all. And so the video, yep, okay. It is about. I couldn't say keyboard lagging. I couldn't figure that out. Maybe keyboard is not as sensitive as a mouse, I would say. But when I played War Thunder, I had a huge mouse lagging, and it was more often in my wireless mouse than my cable mouse, but it was still unbearable. You can't have it. So what I did is, I can only recommend you have to patch through your USB ports and give your virtual machine the real USB port and the real mouse, and that sorted it out for me. So what I did here is I went for VCI, something like that. No. How did it, how's it called? VFIO. VFIO PC config. So that's the one I used. And if you go in settings, here it is. You click on it, and it gives you actually. If you want to test it, you don't know where your USB port is. Just put a certain USB stick in, or USB drive, that you can say, okay, I can identify it. If it's Lexmark, Samsung, whatever, right? And you see, I made a little mistake. I patched through that non-essential instrumentation, advanced micro device. Stop Japanese reserves SPPP. However, I don't want to go through through the whole hassle. And so I patched through. These are from my motherboard, and this is a PCI card I plugged in with four USB 3. Yeah, and of course my graphic card is in, but that I use normally. So, however, this tool, where is it? Settings. So this little thing here, this script VFI-PCI config makes your life so easy to patch through your USB. You just put the USB stick in where you want before you run this script because it has to see it first, right? And then you will see what is what and where is it. Like the Kingston 2.0, that is my boot USB drive from Unraid. So I can't patch this one through. I get in trouble. It's a no-no. One of those. This is my PCI card, and I think this one is my front USB, and these are my back USBs. And in the back USBs, I got my a hub in with keyboard and stuff like that, and it works. So if you have mouse lagging and it's unbearable, patch your or pass through your USB ports. Really, really works. And to make it easy on at least on Unraid, I can tell you. Go download in apps, download or install the VFIO-PCI config script, and this will do it. See, it's listening everything up, and you just click it, click, 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 and then you say build via this, build VFI PCI config, save, then you have to reboot, and it's all doing okay. That's how I did it. And if you have trouble that your machines don't work afterwards anymore, like I had, watch my other video about it. So if you have the PCI no vendor or unknown vendor mistake or fault. There's another video. Just look at this. So, nevertheless, I really like the idea of having
tons. Look what I got here. I mean, this is bare metal, this is bare metal. That means they're running on real hardware. This is running as a normal virtual machine, normal virtual machine, normal virtual machine. This isn't installed yet, I think. I don't even know if I installed it. I haven't done it yet. I have to install Office. This will be purely just for work. These are just gaming. This is gaming the necessarily the most important games, because it's a virtual disk, and I don't want to make it bigger than that. I don't want to add a second one only in worst case scenario. For anything else, I've got my bare metal 2 terabyte hard drive. That will be fine. Ubuntu MX, I've got my War Thunder installed. That will be fine for me. And yeah, totally great. What else I did, and you can look that up if you want, at Space Invader 1. So he has that user script. You need both. You need to have the script for... oh, where are they? Let me see. Plugins. Is it plugins or settings? Let's see. Unbalanced, blah, 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 blah. Was maybe plugins? Oh man, this takes one. So for this tab, custom tab, I think it's called. Let's go here. Let's see. Custom tab. So if you can type, we have a huge advantage. So custom tab, you need this because I added the start VMS. And user scripts, I think. Oh, there they are. You install these ones. And then you can add your stuff like what I did here. I got that from Space Invader 1. So start my bare metal thing. So I go in here, say edit script, and I added sleep space 30, then a new line virsh virsh space start space is the name of your machine. If it has a space, let's say if it's bare metal space VM10, then you have to put it in columns. Otherwise, what columns? Well, these two things on the top, whatever they're called, and then it will work. What I mean is those. See, you would have to put it in this. If that would be bare metal VM10 like this, right? Then you have to put it in these things. But without that, you don't. Or I can just go cancel. Doink. So here I got my machines. I've got 30 seconds then to fire up the next machine. And this is all there is. Yeah, it was a terrible thing with mouse lagging. I said, oh man, I lost so many games. Not so many. I figured it out very quick. And it is so annoying. And for me, the best solution was just patch USB port through, put your real mouse in there, your real keyboard, and it's totally fine. It's just, it's gone. It's good in all my machines. The lag was even in Linux. I mean, in Windows is almost granted, but it even happened in Linux. So what is my next thing? I think I will add some machines. And I have to make some short videos. In a moment, I've got my little dog upstairs. She has eaten, can't get out. It's pouring bucket rain. We have so much water on the road already. So she needs a boat to go potty. I will go out with her. I will see what I can do with that poor little thing. And however, long story short, yeah, there will be a kind of a new series I will start. So at least you will have some videos every now and then. They're not the most informative. Let's see. I'll just show you what I mean when I show you, and you let me know what you think about it. And I think it's not a bad idea. I miss a guy on YouTube. He did that. He always said, not bad, not bad at all. So that's a regional thing, I think, where he comes from. Like in England, there are some places where they always say, you know. Every sentence is finished with you know. So and they have the not bad at all thing. So and I miss his videos. I can't find him anymore. No clue why and what's happening, but he's not there anymore. Phew. So yeah, this is Unraid. I mean, Unraid to me is a... How can I say this? I haven't tried Proxmox yet, but Unraid is absolutely easy to use. What I love most is you can extend, shrink, exchange hard drives, bigger, smaller, as long as you got enough space to distribute everything you want, you can do everything with it. Like with any other, with Open Media Vault, if you use, what is that called, their RAID? They have a RAID system. It's the same idea like what Unraid is using. Oh, forgot it. Yeah, you have to use a certain file system and it has a certain RAID configuration. A plugin you have to download. I forgot it. Man, I'm so terribly bad, right? However, man, I should have a script next time I make a video. But I didn't want to talk about OMV. However, I think I will run this as a test soon, just to see how it goes and play around with it. And you get my thoughts in from OMV. And then I'll give you the name of the guy who is the Space Invader 1 for Open Media Vault. This guy is just great. He does everything what Space Invader does with Unraid. He does that with Open Media Vault. Not the same things, but he explains everything and helps you out. And it's great. Absolutely great. However, this video was supposed to be really, 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 really short. It is just about my mouse luck, so it's totally gone. It was in Linux, it was in Windows, gaming was impossible. You needed to turn the plane or the tank, it just didn't move, and oh, then you hit the mouse like everybody does it, right? It's not the mouse, it's electronic, it didn't get through. There's a thing you can edit something in the registry of Windows, but I mean, Windows is self-destructing anyway, so why accelerate it, right? So I'd rather keep my fingers out of it if I don't have to use it. Otherwise, if you have to use it, you have to use it. But this is it. Okay, guys. This is Ubuntu. And you can see I've got quite some RAM. And I changed my... that's maybe an interesting one if somebody really gets to here. So I gave it only 8 cores. So it's 4 cores and 4 threads. Because I saw... I'm good in breadcrumb finding. That somebody had a 16-core like I have, 8 CPUs, 8 threads, the Ryzen 7 3600, I think it is, and he had micro lugs. When he gave like I gave 10 or 12 of these, let's call them CPUs, and he discovered every now and then he had micro lugs, and when he separated it, like what? Oh, let's see, like I did it here. So I give 0 to 4, or zero, yeah, the first 4 CPUs, I gave that to Unraid, and I took all the others. So you see, it's half-half. I've done the same with my bare metal, and play-wise, I haven't found... I give it a little bit more here. I give it more. But yeah, with this configuration, I haven't found anything. I think when I took these two off, I had a little trouble. There was a lag happening for a moment on the video game itself, not my keyboard, not my mouse. So it might have been too little CPU power. But I'm going to try this out again and play longer what I did here, because that's what he recommended and he was a gamer too. And so I will try this out. That is supposed to be the best configuration because Ryzen, yeah, that's the way it has to be in what he said. And he used CPU 0 to 4, so, I mean, 4 CPUs, so 0, that's 1, 2, oh, sorry, 2, 3, 4. And I give it the cores 2, so I'm not separating them. I did at the bare metal, but I haven't had any trouble there. I will see, if I don't have to optimize anything, I don't optimize anything. Here's my normal game thingy, game windows. And here I have it like set like this, and I will see what that does. I want to compare them to the bare metal. And that's the only difference, except it runs on a really hard drive, and that shouldn't make any difference. All right, so this is it. I'm absolutely impressed with Unraid. I love Synology, but with Synology, you're really limited to their hardware, right? And you can't just mix. You can mix drives, but you can't swap and change and enlarge and shrink, and it's not possible. And I love Unraid. If you don't want to spend money, I trust Open Media Vault can do it too. And oh, what's it called? It's something with the name is RAID from the plugin. If you, well, let's try this. SnapRAID, that's the one. You want SnapRAID? Oh man, Google, right? Is that great having Google SnapRAID? That's what you want. That's the same. I will do the same. Same function. Only Oh, by the way, this is the guy here. Techno Dad, live. This guy is a Space Invader 1 for Open Media Vault. So if you want to look into Open Media Vault, that's the guy, Techno Dad Live. That's the one. I really just hope that somebody looks to the end. Here, so you can have Merge FS. I think that's the best one. So Merge FS, I think, is the right thing with using with SnapRaid. Some use Union File System, but I think the Merge FS is better. However, I can only base it on my feelings, so we'll be fine. And you can see I'm just not up and running, right? Not the way I was. I have too much trouble. I had a long weekend. Let's say my wife came home and turned into the other person. And man, this is a nightmare. You don't want to live like that. I think hormones, demon possessed. What do I know? I have no clue what's going on there. No idea. Absolute no idea. I can't recognize that person. It's impossible. It's not the same character. It's nowhere near the character. I don't know that person. And I don't want to know that person. Absolutely not. However, long story short, I should make a Mandela video again, right? Because there is so much going on that is... And don't get me started with COVID, right? Man, I mean, you should know my opinion without me saying anything. All right. Okay. Yeah, guys, so if you have Lux in keyboard or mouse, just in a virtual machine, and I would think it works with every virtual machine, patch or pass through the real hardware, and I don't think you will have it anymore. Mine is gone, my problem. It's totally fine. I can play now. Okay, this is now really a short video. See you soon. Love you all. Yep. Bye.